Hi, it's Bruce. It's a nice Sunday, and we had a busy weekend seeing a couple shows. The first one, as you could see from the playbill, was The Farnsworth Invention, played by Aaron Sorkin of West Wing fame, but he wrote A Few Good Men. Not one of my favorite plays, but I actually like The Farnsworth Invention. It takes a lot of concentration. There's a lot of talking and explaining about the invention of television and the creators around that. And the audience seemed to be really into it. It stars Hank Azaria as David Sarnoff, who wound up being the president of RCA, which spun off NBC and all the... He started the initial radio broadcasts and was the first one to start into television. And it's basically about how David Sarnoff sort of stole the creation of television from Philo T. Farnsworth, played by an actor who I didn't know, and his name is Jimmy Simpson. He's a wonderful actor, and he really got the exuberance of the invention of Philo Farnsworth and his creativity, but then his troublesome goings-on inside and his alcoholism. It was very interesting play, as I said. I think that I can't highly recommend it to a lot of people in a way, because it costs so much money. We got good tickets at $30 from TDF, but if I'm thinking of entertainment value, I don't know if I'd highly recommend it to other people. I will recommend it as a good play, and take that for what it is. The next thing we saw was Make Me a Song, the William Finn review. It's a review of the music and lyrics of William Finn, who's not my favorite composer, but I like a lot of his stuff, especially falsettos. What surprised me about this was how entertaining that it was, and I think that's due in part to a great cast. The cast is, I'm going to mention them all by name because they all deserve to be mentioned, Sandy Binion, if I get the pronunciations wrong, I apologize, Adam Heller, Sally Wilford, and my personal favorite, D.B. Bonds, who's adorably handsome. He also sings my favorite song, my favorite William Finn song, I'd Rather Be Sailing. This was really well directed, and it's 90 minutes. It goes along pretty fast. It's a preview, so I think it'll tighten up even more. They can condense it a little bit, would be my only criticism. But with the songs I'd Rather Be Sailing and Heart and Music from A New Brain, I love that song. And they do a lot of songs from falsettos all together called the Falsetto Suite. It's almost like seeing a mini March of the Falsettos all together. I think they could rename this show. Instead of making a song, I'd really rather see it called Heart and Music, because I like that song. All right, so I highly recommend actually both of those shows for completely different reasons, and we really had an enjoyable Saturday. Okay, for my farewell, I just want to mention that I had a fun time last weekend when my cousin Valerie from Cleveland came to visit. She saw her first Broadway musical, which I always think is a treat. It was Spring Awakening. I didn't go with her, I'd seen it, and she highly enjoyed it. So that was fun to know that Valerie saw her first Broadway musical. And we also had a wonderful Halloween and dinner with my very good friend, Nick Searley. We had him Wednesday for dinner before he went to his own birthday party. Nice happy birthday dinner on Halloween. What a birthday to have. And so I did a little video interview, a little comic interview with Nick before dinner. So I'm going to show that next. And right after that, I'm going to show a little clip that Bill accidentally took. Bill was, before I got home, because I don't get home till dark this time of year, he saw one of the most beautiful sunsets that we had out of our window in years. And so he grabbed the camera and went to take a photo. Lo and behold, it was on movie mode, and Bill doesn't know how to work the camera because it's complicated, and he couldn't get it off movie mode. So he actually took a little movie, and then it wound up being jiggly at the end because he didn't know what to do. But I thought I'd use it because it shows how beautiful our sunsets can be. So hope you're having a great weekend. We did. Thanks a lot.
He never liked to look right into it.
He doesn't like to look at the camera. Hi, Nick.
Hey, Bruce.
Happy birthday.
Thanks, Bruce.
We have our friend Nick Searley over for his birthday before he's throwing his big party. We won't say how old Nick is yet. No.
No, I'm 27.
Nick is 27. Nick is my, as you all know, my number one friend on on MySpace. And I love him dearly, and we're making Bill is making filet of sole for him tonight for his birthday dinner. Nick has been traveling a little, and I want to know how your trip was. You went to Ohio.
I went to Ohio. I took Calvin, my dog, to Ohio.
And what was the best thing that you did at home? That's your hometown, Hamilton.
Yes, I saw my nieces and nephews, and for my birthday, they got me a Fairfield High School Indians hoodie. So now I have a piece of Fairfield.
It's the Fairfield Indians?
Yeah.
Ah, like Cleveland, the Cleveland Indians.
Yes, but we don't, like... Cincinnati, red.
But I know. I know. Well, I was trying to put the Indians together. And then you went to?
New Orleans.
Great. Because your boyfriend Eric is there.
Yes.
And that's your first trip to New Orleans?
I've never been.
Never been. How did you like it?
I loved it. I loved it. I did not want to leave. It was so pretty, and the French Quarter was really great.
And you had great food?
Oh, I had crawfish, potato, and corn chowder. It was incredible.
And it was nice to see Eric.
Yes. And the dog is there now. Calvin is there.
And what's coming up this week for you? Do you know? Do you have plans?
This week? No. I have some things up in the air, but I don't know what's happening. I might go to Boston.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to say happy birthday. And just to say, I hope you have a nice dinner. Bill's doing all the work because I worked all day. So he's in the kitchen now, chopping and scrubbing and doing everything while we're sitting here making movies.
Making magic.
Okay, well, happy birthday.